Good evening and welcome. Tonight we will be going over the history and geography of Amazonas in Colombia. This is Amazon Week on my channel. We are exploring the various regions of the Amazon, and tonight we're exploring Colombia's. Now, geography is fairly simple in that it's covered by the Amazon. The Amazon River makes up this border right here. But that doesn't mean that that's the only river, of course. The largest river would be the Caquetá River, cutting right through there. But the region is covered in the Amazon. It is lush, beautiful, thick rainforest, covering 100% of the area. So that's pretty much it for geography. And I actually did not find a lot of history of this region, but what I did find was very interesting, and it mainly centers around the town here, or the city I should say, of Leticia. There's a lot of conflicting stories about how it was named Leticia, all of them after various women. We're not sure which woman was the Leticia that this was named after, but nevertheless, you can see it's literally on the border here with Brazil and Peru, this three-point border. So, who do you think founded this town? It was founded in 1867, not by the Colombians, not by the Brazilians, by the Peruvians, building an outpost along the Amazon River. In 1922, there was a treaty agreement trying to draw borders because, my goodness, there were a lot of border wars in South America, mainly due to the fact that there's no way to delineate borders other than rivers. You can see but it was agreed that this side of the river would go to Colombia if Colombia recognized a claim over on the border with Ecuador and Peru. Apparently that was a good compromise, and Leticia became a Colombian town. But some Peruvian people were not pleased about that. A decade later, in 1932, a band of about 200 Peruvians sailed over the river and invaded the town and occupied it and said, "This is Peruvian once again." Apparently Bogota didn't hear about it for a few weeks because this is in the middle of nowhere. But when they did, they were incensed and they sent soldiers down to take the town back. It turned into a whole conflict, which is, it can be called the Colombian-Peruvian War, or just the Leticia War, which is a better name. But it was a whole to-do. It was full-on battles against the Colombian army and these rogue Peruvians. And then once, you know, the Peruvians were like, "Oh, we need help," they went to the government of Peru, and the government of Peru backed them up and sent soldiers. It was turning into an all-out war over this little bit of land here, until the Peruvian president was assassinated, and the new president was like, "This is dumb, call this off, we don't need this war, just let Colombia have it, they legally have it anyway," and the war was called off. So Colombia was like, "How are we gonna keep Peru from invading our land on this side of the Amazon? This place is in the middle of nowhere, it's mainly an indigenous population." Rubber was the big thing in the area, and transport along the river here, since it's Colombia's only access to the Amazon. How can we keep Peru from invading this little place in the middle of nowhere? What they did was they told a lot of people in Bogota, "Hey, you know what's some real prime real estate right now? Leticia. Gotta check it out. lots of opportunities there. You can start anything you want, because there's a whole lot of nothing there besides the rainforest. And many people from Colombia's major cities, mostly Bogota, moved into Leticia in the, like, 1940s, 1950s. And pretty much every Colombian that lives there now came during that kind of migration period, in a way, populated the town. Amazonas was officially made a province of Colombia in 1991, sorry, Department of Colombia in 1991. And that's pretty much all the history that I could find. Like, again, not a lot, but what was there? Very interesting. A whole war between Peru and Colombia there over who got to control this little corner here. I guess Brazil was just nonplussed about the whole thing. They have their own city on the other side here. But yeah, the middle ground where all these three countries meet is in the middle of the river officially. I'll show it to you on Google Earth, but I'm gonna have to move this angle real quick. Let me set up my tablet first. And because this is a big, long page on my atlas, so I'm gonna slide you down. All right. Here's Amazonas, Colombia. I'm gonna highlight, let's highlight Leticia. And I'll zoom out so you can see exactly where we are in the world. We are crooked. There we go. So here you can see northern South America. There's Colombia. And way down here is Leticia, in the middle of the Amazon. You can see just how green and lush it is. Nowhere on earth does it get greener and lusher than this. There are some neat things here in Leticia to see. Let's start off with the slideshow of, was it this park? Park Santander? Yes, this park. I think a lot of these pictures in the slideshow aren't of the park, but they're great pictures, so I'm going to show it to you. This is the park for sure. There's a beautiful church. I really like it. Very modern, isn't it? Well, like modern. Like it's not like a classic Spanish church, you know. It's definitely made in the 20th century. The big lily pads that are famous along the Amazon. A really cool Leticia Amazonas sign. Some cool artwork tuck into this tree stump here. Look at the big skies, a memorial here for, I wonder if it's for the Leticia War, but it's too blurry, I can't read it. Looks like a list of people who passed. Maybe it was like people who served in World War II or something based on the fit. Maybe World War I. I don't know. The sign is blurry. Lots of pretty artwork. Here's the inside of probably that pretty modern church that we saw. There's this huge pond here that's full of, like, watery plants. And I love this sign. Because not only do you see the animals, there's the boto, the anaconda, scarlet macaw, etc., etc., jaguars, fish. The E here is the flag of Brazil, the flag of Colombia, and the flag of Peru. Because this is the point where all three countries touch. There's an important guy. I wonder if that's Oriana. Judging by his fit, he lived a long time ago. Big beautiful tree there. And it says on Google Earth that this park is famous for its birds. So I assume that there's a point. I thought these were bats at first, but I assume that, you know, the birds all come out at dawn and dusk. Make a big racket. Cool boto statue. The water lilies. Oh, there's the church. Look how pretty. Water lilies. They're not lilies. just watery plants. And this really pretty statue here, I assume, is baby Jesus, I assume. It's really neat. Look, it's the same shape as the church. This is where we're going next. The History Museum. Let's check it out. There's some incredible indigenous artwork in this museum. Look at these, like figurines, I suppose. They're incredible. Looks like some kind of, there's a bow, so maybe weapons, some stools there to rest your head on. A headdress, so beautiful. Look at these, maybe some flutes. Looks like, I love this, that's adorable. Happy guy. Another cool figurine, another beautiful headdress. Just the artwork here, even this little monkey man. It's just so incredible because, you know, all of this is made out of things they found in the forest. There's the boto. Beautiful headdress and like a sash. Not sure what that is, but I like it. It's neat carving there. Some more beautiful feathers made into items. Looks like canoe paddles. Don't know what that is. Let's see. Tubular squeezers hung from the Maloko roof to press the cassava and extract its poison. Well, I did not know cassava was poisonous. Maybe Amazonian ones are. Baskets. And some necklaces here with feline teeth. Incredible. How neat is that? So here's the town. You can see nothing quite much separates the town from the Brazilian side. But if we head over here to the Amazon River, here's the point where three countries meet. Isn't that neat? That rhymed. Mount Sinai. Hold on, I didn't see that before. That didn't pop up. What's Mount Sinai doing here? It's a camp. I thought it would be a cool mountain. It's not. It's some kind of like church camp or something. Oh, I'm in Brazil. Never mind. But that's probably why I didn't look at it. I love this Amazon world. Let's check out Amazon world. They've got a big hut here. I assume these are the names of tribes. Trees. Can do archery. Let's see all the plant life. Eat some amazing looking food. Flowers, do some crafts maybe, or see some crafts. See a cute fish. I think that's a piranha though, so don't get too close. See the natural fruit here. And maybe even have like a dinner show, I guess. Really cool. Love Amazon world. One thing though that, let's see if I can find it on my own without looking it up. One place, here it is, that every website I went to for Amazonas Colombia said you have to go to Isla de los Micos, which if you know your Spanish means Island of the Monkeys. You can see these sweet little spider monkeys that just roam the area. Oh, that's cool. A little dance they're putting on. You can see monkeys all over the place. Every website I saw mentioned this place, which I can imagine why. These are sweet little mischievous guys. Here's the big lily pads. Maybe you could like sit on that. I wonder how much weight they support. But yeah, there's a better picture over here of like the dream. The monkeys. Oh, he's so cute. Let's see. Where is it? This. The dream. Just being covered in spider monkeys. Not being covered in spiders. Spider monkeys. That's the fun. That's what I would like to do. I also saw when I was exploring Monkey Island, this Comunidad Indígena Yagua. A little village here. Where you can see some of these cool, like, statue figurine things. And see a cool presentation, meet the locals, and see their big trees that they love, and get some face paint from this cool guy. Look Look at his little jaguar stuff. Looks like a nice man. Look how friendly. Let's head up into the Amazon. Into the Amazon. To look at some of the national parks here in Colombia. See the sights, because like we just looked at Amazonas, Brazil yesterday, which is the area around the Amazon River. We just looked at the area on the Amazon River. So this is just pure rainforest. No Amazon River. But obviously lots of waterways. I think I have the hiccups. Look at these big old trees. You can take all kinds of tours there. See, we aren't even in the bulk of it yet. Like, what we just looked at was in this tiny bit. This is the rest of the department. How neat is that? So let's look at these parks real quick. There we go. Very beautiful, the big lily pads, the Victoria lily pads. Cool hiking there, maybe. Oh, that looks like a fun place to explore. I'm sure it's hot as could be. You gotta take a plane there, because it's in the middle of nowhere. You can't just show up. You need to arrange a, you need a plan. Let's see. Cajunari. I'd love to canoe. Not the Amazon, but in the Amazon. And see just everything as naturally as possible, like that. And see the botos, the pink dolphins, and the big lily pads. Hike these trails, there it goes. The beautiful waterfalls, too. Oh, look at this guy flying free at the water. Amazing. These beautiful plants. And the Amazon is, I think it's the most biodiverse place in the world. You can find so many varieties of plants, animals, insects, everything. I think everything else is just little towns along the rivers here. Which, I mean, I've tried to find slideshows. Here's one. The rapids here. How beautiful is that? Ooh, she's king of the mountain. Oh, look at the birds. It's so beautiful. Oop. Be careful. It's a danger noodle. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, I love that. The rainforest, right? You can't have the rainforest. Yeah, I'm going to end it there. Highly encourage you to explore this area yourself on Google Earth. See if you can find any other cool pictures, because, you know, it's very random for me to actually find some. I've been looking around. It's a lot of nothing because it's the middle of nowhere. So, let me know if you find. Thank you so much for watching. If you want more Amazon, next video we're going to be hopping down to Peru. So be sure to subscribe so you won't miss out. I hope that you found this video relaxing and educational, and I hope that you have a good, good, good day.